I decided to take our performances to the next level, pushing the actors and the text to the limits. For the last 4 weeks, our actors have undergone an extensive rehearsal process where they are required to stay in character day in and day out. I feel that this method acting exercise helps our actors not only understand their characters, really feel what their characters are feeling, staying in their mindset 24/7. This technique has been a great success and has benefited our cast immensely. In fact, I don't even think they're actors anymore. They have become their characters, and as their characters, they'll spend their offstage time connecting and observing their fellows with you, our beloved audience. And I hope, as you watch some of our performances come alive tonight, you feel not only immersed in the story, but like you're a part of it. Now, without much ado, please enjoy your meals and please enjoy the performances. We are now proud to present Hamlet.
Who's there?
Nay, answer me.
Stand and unfold yourself.
Along with the king.
Bernardo?
He.
You come most carefully upon your hour.
'Tis hour struck 12. Get thee to bed, Francisco.
For this relief, much thanks. For 'tis bitter cold, and I am sick at heart.
Have you had quiet guard?
Sure no one leaves. I'll be back as soon as I can. I'm sorry for the inconvenience, but there's nothing we can do. Please remain calm.
Well, you know what they say. The show must go on.
Oh my.
We mustn't let this incident spoil our patron's evening. Let me play the part of Hamlet. Let the audience look to their eyes. I will move storms. I will condole in some measure. To be. Or not to be. That is the question.
This question is down, Nick Bottom. This is no time for your giant ego.
A man was just killed right under all of our noses. This is serious.
Yeah, there's a murderer on the loose.
Well, we can't just sit here and wait for the police to show up.
My sister's boyfriend is dead.
Sister? I don't recall you having a sister. Beatrice!
Oh, for the love of God, Billy, a man is dead. Could you forget your goddamn method acting for 5 minutes and let us see our real selves?
I can't believe he's gone.
Well, if there's a murderer here, then we need to figure out who it is, and we need to figure it out now.
Yes. They must pay the ultimate price!
Calm down, Lady Macbeth. No one else needs to get hurt, but we do need to solve this crime, and fast.
I like the way you think, Beatrice. What say you and I lead this little investigation?
Sounds good to me.
You know, I've always admired the way you stand up for what's right. You've got a real backbone.
Thank you, and I've always admired your... determination.
The two of us could make a hell of a team.
It's a damn shame the bard didn't write us into the same show.
Ugh, no, I could never act in a comedy. There are too many happy people at the end.
Oh, and the weddings.
Why is there always more than one wedding? Why is it always an absurd number? It's okay to date before you get hitched, people. Take your time.
Take it from me, honey. Sometimes it's better to stay single.
Well, I do prefer it to a tragedy, though.
No, tragedy is the way to go.
Oh, I don't know. The female characters are always so much better in the comedies.
Oh, sure. Just ask Katharina and Bianca what strong female characters they are.
Well, at least in the comedies, women don't all end up, dead. And most of them are pretty badass. There's Rosalind from whatever that one's called. And there's me. It doesn't get much better than me.
I'm offended. Lady Macbeth is every great actress's dream role. And not all tragedies are that awful.
Name one.
Othello.
You're kidding.
Iago is still alive at the end. Such a tragic hero, never truly achieving the position he deserves, but he lives, I guess.
That is literally the worst role model I have ever heard of.
Well, that is literally your opinion. And don't we have like a murderer on the loose?
Right. Let's start by rounding up our suspects. Who was backstage at the time of the murder?
They were backstage, it was their show. But we should still talk to them. Everyone get up here, now!
I'm already back here.
A little faster.
Sorry.
Come on.
This is so stupid.
Sit. Are you happy?
You guys were the only ones not in the audience during the time of the murder, so one of you has to be the culprit.
Let the interrogations begin. Let's start with the cast of Hamlet. Ophelia, you were the one who found Hamlet's body. Did you find his body, or did you murder his body?
Murder his body?
You're right, I got excited. Did you kill him or not, Ophelia?
I did not kill him. I tripped over him. He'd been hit over the head or something. And besides, why would I want to kill my own boyfriend anyway?
Don't you mean ex-boyfriend?
No, I mean boyfriend, Juliet. We hadn't broken up.
Oh, well, that's awkward.
Wait, you two hadn't broken up?
No, why would you guys think that?
He told me you had. That's the only reason why I said I'd go out with him.
Horatio, you what?
I'm so sorry.
How long have you two been a thing?
Only about a week or so. I'm so sorry, Ophelia. I would never ever.
And now he's dead.
Alas, poor Horatio.
He he swept me off my feet. He told me that Ophelia had broken up with him and that we could be together. I was just so happy. I never thought he'd lie to me.
That son of a bitch.
So let me get this straight. He was dating both of you? Oh, that boy, such a gem. Couldn't make up his own mind. Just like the real Hamlet.
That asshole, Ophelia.
Oh, no, I'm serious, Horatio. How can he do that to us?
I don't know why. Maybe he didn't mean to. Maybe it was a misunderstanding here. Maybe he really did love the both of us.
Well, screw him. He's a two-timing floozy.
You know, I spell probable cause.
I didn't know he was two-timing. Ignorance isn't motive.
A likely story.
Ophelia!
I don't even know why you're questioning me. At least I was supposed to be backstage at the time. Why aren't you questioning Demetrius? He was hanging around there like a creep with us.
Yeah, he and Hamlet almost started fighting each other before the show. I had to pull them apart.
Whoa! I may have wanted to punch the guy, but that doesn't mean I would kill him.
Well, why were the two of you fighting?
It sounds suspicious to me.
Demetrius!
Well, if you must know, he got all pissy because I was hitting on his boyfriend. But I don't know what he got so worked up about. I hit on everybody.
Yeah.
Except Helena. She scares me.
Well, that's still suspect.
Wait, you knew we were dating too?
Well, you weren't exactly subtle about it, sweetie.
But why would you try to get Hamlet angry?
I wasn't trying to get him angry. I was trying to get you excited. This is ridiculous! Can't we just wait for the police?
No, this is fun!
No, I agree with Billy. This is going nowhere, and we're just going to become suspicious of one another. I don't want my daughter hearing her entire cast accused of murder.
That's a suspicious thing to say!
Stop! He has a point.
just a child.
Dad, I'm 17.
That is legally childhood.
She was backstage at the time of the murder. We just want to know if she saw anything.
But you aren't real police officers. You have no authority over us.
Yeah, I'm not talking until somebody reads me my Miranda rights.
Good Lord, Miranda, not now.
There seems to have been a lot of hostility between actors recently.
Doing what?
Yeah, Miranda, have you noticed anyone fighting backstage recently?
Well, there's Tybalt and Romeo, as usual. Edmund and Edgar have been at each other's throats all week. There's Caesar and, like, his entire class. Over on Titania, oh, and Pericles swears the whole universe is against him, but he's always so dramatic. Oh, and there's Billy and my dad.
Miranda?
And
what was that, Miranda?
Prospero and Billy are fighting.
We've been fighting?
When did this start? Around last summer? Billy and my dad have been friends for years, and we always go to the beach together every summer.
Oh, I remember this. You were upset about this.
My God, Billy, of course we were upset.
You guys know how Billy can be a little extreme with his method acting exercises?
Yes!
Right, but I'm sure you all know, in The Tempest, Prospero is left abandoned at sea for many, many years. And well, Billy thought it would be—
Oh, I was trying to help you!
You left us at the beach in the middle of nowhere! You took our phones, our supplies, we had nothing! We had to walk 5 miles to civilization and there was a literal tempest afoot!
I think you're being a tad bit dramatic about the whole thing.
It was an exercise! I was trying to help you!
It was a dick move, Billy.
A random language.
I'm just quoting you, Dad.
Look, it was an exercise! I was trying to help all of you! I wanted you to channel your resentment into your roles, not at me!
You know, Billy, I don't blame him for being pissed at you. I was pretty mad about that time you left me in the middle of the forest.
Oh, you enjoyed that.
That's not the point. There were bugs. Do you know how hot it is in the middle of the night in July on a midsummer's night?
Oh my God. Or that time you made a complete ass out of me in public.
You do that yourself all the time, Nick Bottom.
What? Or the time that you pushed me into a swimming pool.
Yeah, or how about the time that you made me
shut up! All of you, this isn't helping.
Oh, right. All right,
okay.
Billy, what did you see backstage? Who would want to kill Hamlet?
I don't know. Claudius!
Dude! Can you focus? Please?
All right. I saw Hamlet talking to Macbeth backstage when I was out to do my intro speech. Maybe she had something to do with it.
Where's my idiot? Sweetie?
What?
Why weren't you called up with everyone else?
Oh, well, part of my pre-show ritual every year is Stephen came to relax before I go on.
So let me get this straight. You are reading instead of interacting.
Billy, you have your methods and I have mine. I've been doing productions here for 10 years now. I think I know what I'm doing at this point.
Ah, Stephen King, the true genius.
What are you talking about? I have given you his books to read for several Christmases now, and you have never read any of them.
Honey, just because I haven't read them doesn't mean that I don't know that they are works of genius.
Actually, it kind of does.
What the kid said. And if you'd have read them, we'd have more to talk about.
I get tired of just hearing about your Game of Thrones theories all the time.
I thought you liked Game of Thrones!
I do, but I can only handle so much violence.
Ma'am, up!
Really?
Really? We're going there, man?
Yeah, maybe we are going there.
All right. Okay. So, you were backstage at the time of the murder reading.
Yes, I like to read in the green room.
And did you run into Hamlet at all?
Actually, yes. I was going to go get my book in the car. I had left it. And Hamlet stopped me. He was getting pre-show jitters, and he asked me for advice on how to relax. I do a lot of yoga.
Oh, sure. You calmed him down before you murdered him.
What? Why would I want to murder him?
Because you're Macbeth!
I swear to God, Billy, I am not actually Macbeth!
Okay. So, you were giving Hamlet some relaxation tips. Yeah. Then what happened?
I told him to break a leg and I went to sit down. But I did see Juliet talking to him as I was leaving.
That's right. Juliet, what were you doing backstage?
Who, me? Okay, so I was getting a little bored interacting with the audience. Everyone always comes up to me like I'm this big authority on true love, and I'm like, dude, have you seen this play? So I headed backstage to chill. I had seen Puck talking to the apothecary, and I wanted to tell him not to be an idiot, because that apothecary, not to be trusted. But I couldn't find Puck anywhere, which isn't surprising, so I was just gonna watch the show from the wings. I mean, I said hi to Hamlet, but that's all.
Well, where was Puck then?
How should I know?
Hey, wait.
Come to think of it, where's Puck now?
Hey, yeah, where is Puck now?
Yeah! Where is Puck?
For the love of God, Puck, would you get your ass up here now?
Oh, my ass is already up there. I bottom. Get it through my ass.
Oh, fuck you, Puck.
What are you talking about, my girl like that?
Puck is a star.
The only true talent in the entire company.
Yes. Oh, it is true. Now let us not pick on Nick Bottom anymore, shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Puck, would you get up here?
Hang on, I'm making a scene.
Oh my God,
do we? Really?
What?
Puck?
Now, Puck? Come on.
Hey, Puck, be here.
Ugh.
Come on.
Wait, one more scene.
Dude.
And?
Are you kidding me?
Nope. We'll see.
What are you doing?
How is this helping?
And?
This isn't helping anything.
Now, you're right.
Yes!
Puck, get your ass over here!
Puck! My God!
What were you doing backstage at the time of Hamlet's murder?
Oh, you know, wandering.
Wandering?
Well, I do wander everywhere.
Yeah, but why were you wandering there?
Did you know that Bottom was also backstage at the time of the murder? Why aren't we questioning her?
Because we're questioning you!
Oh, did you know that Bottom hates Hamlet? Did you know that Bottom hates Hamlet?
Stop trying to change the subject!
Did you know that Bottom also?
What is your problem, Huck? I was just backstage to tell everyone to break a leg.
Literally, right?
Wait, you were?
Yes, is that really that hard to believe?
Yes.
I am a very nice person. Sometimes.
You've never told anyone to break a leg before.
Well, there's a first time for everything. It was opening night. I wanted to promote a sense of camaraderie, of well-being. That's not a crime, is it?
No, but it is incredibly out of character.
Yeah. True.
I shook hands with Hamlet Sr., gave my best to Gertrude, telling the stagehands how magnificent they are. I even joined in on one of those, like, little warm-up games, one of those tongue twisters. Really, I was being a positive team player. I even waved to Prospero as he had...
Wait. Prospero! What were you doing backstage?
What?
Dad, just tell them.
Tell us what?
Nothing.
Is this a confession, Miranda?
Miranda, stop!
Well, what are you trying to hide from?
What are you telling
us? Come on, just tell us!
I don't know what you're asking for.
Stop! I'll tell you. My dad was really upset with Billy because of the whole speech incident and just disgruntled in general. He's been doing this play for years, and Billy just is not one of the trees actors. So, he wanted to get back at Billy, so he messed with the rigging system backstage, and—
I killed him!
You killed Hamlet to get back at Billy?
No, it's not quite like that.
That's enough! I need some pie. I think we could all use some pie. Can we get some pie up here right now on the stage, please?
But we're not playing here.
We can take 15 minutes. The people need pie.
I need pie.
And if I hear one more actor say a stupid thing.
A stupid thing.
I am going to add to the evening's body count.
Okay, fine. We will take a short recess for dessert, and then we'll reconvene.
Great. Thank
you, Miranda.
You definitely killed him.
I definitely did not.
Listen, I'm a spiteful bitch, but I'm not a stupid spiteful bitch.
Billy has put us through a lot of mental abuse, and I just want to know if it seems rational or not to try and get a new director.
I think he'll be in jail by the end of that because he killed Hamlet, so I think you killed Hamlet.
Why do you think I killed Hamlet?
Because I think you want, because he dies in the play and you want him to be in character so much that you killed him.
Hamlet wasn't supposed to die until Act 5. Did you see Act 5?
I think you went a little overboard and you killed Hamlet.
See, so it just happened early.
Sorry. And also, they want you fired.
That too.
Who wants me fired?
Literally everyone, dude.
Literally everyone.
Well, how about this? You're all fired. I'll make a new play. I'll cast the whole
bunch of you. You hired a psychopath.
Move it!
You are so scary.
She doesn't.
That's right.
No, she doesn't.
I'll shove this pie in your face.
No,
don't. I'll shove it pie in my own face. I'm crazy.
I'm ready.
Fantastic. Now let's get down to business.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
To defeat
the Hun.
No!
No!
No.
Prospero, I believe you had just confessed to murder.
Well, you didn't let me finish. I think I killed Hamlet, but it was an accident.
How do you accidentally murder someone?
It's easier than you think.
But this isn't about Lady Fluffernutter. This is about Hamlet. Listen, I just wanted to mess the show up a little bit. I know that Hamlet is Billy's favorite show.
I don't pay favorites! All of Shakespeare's works are my favorites!
Anyway, I know Hamlet is Billy's favorite show, so I just wanted to send down the wrong set piece. Send the opening act into disarray. Nothing too bad, just enough to upset Billy and enact my revenge for the 5-mile walk in the rain and deep sense of abandonment.
Oh, don't exaggerate!
Wait, so you just messed up the set pieces?
Not on my own. I needed an expert. A messing things up expert. And who better to talk to than...
Talk.
Who? Me?
Yes, you.
Oh, it couldn't be.
Then who? Oh, shut up! What did you do to the set, Pop?
I just wanted him to have a set piece fly in during the opening scene, just to confuse the audience.
But that's not what happened at all.
Well, something must have gone wrong.
Puck, what the fuck? What did you do to Hamlet, Puck?
Puck!
Didn't do anything.
Well, something must have happened since the set didn't even move. What happened?
Nothing! Nothing at all.
Demetrius, what did you do?
What? Are you trying to blame this all on me now? What the hell? I didn't do anything to Hamlet!
You did almost get into a fight with him right before he died.
True. Were you jealous that he got the part of Hamlet instead of you? I know that you played him last year.
Oh, please, I played the part last year! He was basically my understudy.
Well, what were you doing with Puck then?
If you must know, we were just having some fun.
Ew.
Oh.
Some fun?
Well, my dear.
Don't call me dear.
Some, like me, are born great. Others achieve greatness, and some, like Puck, just look like they need greatness thrust upon them.
Ew.
You know what I mean?
Dude, just hate. And seriously, why would that of all people?
Well, I hear he's
no.
Pretty good fellow.
Okay, fine. Where were you flirting with Puck then?
In the wind stage right. We were messing with some ropes.
With ropes? What kind of ropes?
The ones that control the fly system, the set pieces of the crap.
Puck, what the heck did you fuck up?
Well, I was just doing what my old buddy Prospero asked me to, but Demetrius was being all, well, you know. And he kind of distracted me. I pulled the wrong rope, and I think I made some sandbags fall on the stage left wing. But so what? Didn't seem to cause any problems.
Giant sandbags falling from the sky didn't seem like a potential problem.
Medium-sized sandbags. Anyway, I didn't want to get caught messing with the stuff trying to find the correct rope, so I abandoned the plan. I'm sorry, Prospero.
Oh my god. Well, now that you mention it, next to him, there were sandbags next to Hamlet's body. I didn't notice it until now because I was so in shock, but they were there.
You idiot! Have you any idea what you've done? You've killed someone just to mess with that creep! I don't even have words for you.
I wouldn't have done it if you hadn't made me.
Well, if you had done it correctly, there wouldn't be a man dead backstage.
Well, I would have done it if you hadn't asked me to. Billy messed with us all of our lives.
And none of us trying to retaliate, right? Right?
Yeah.
Am I really that bad of a director?
Yes!
I just wanted justice.
You're being ridiculous. You killed Hamlet. Now let's just all go to sleep and forget all of this happened.
No. I'm not the one that dropped the sandbag on his head. That was you.
I would have done it if you hadn't made me.
Oh, really now?
Yeah, really.
You're such a mischievous little brat.
Well, it's better than being a vengeful dick. This isn't my fault at all.
You should have been paying attention.
You should have gotten someone more responsible to do your dirty work. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. You're right. This is my fault.
Uh-huh.
Going to the king of fucking things up for help.
Well, I would have dropped it on it. Demetrius had distracted me, so why don't we blame him?
Well, I wouldn't have come looking for you if Horatio hadn't blown me off earlier.
What am I to you, a side dish?
Yes!
Does this mean this is my fault then? Oh, God. I'm so sorry.
No, you adorable little cinnamon roll. It's all Ophelia's fault.
What?
Ophelia? Me? Oh. So now we're back to blaming Ophelia. This is really problematic discourse, and it's getting us absolutely nowhere.
You were the one who told me to hit on Horatio in the first place, Ophelia.
So it's her fault.
Yes, it's her fault.
And it isn't mine at all. No,
it isn't.
I thought Hamlet was cheating on me, and I wanted to find out for sure, so I asked for Demetrius' help. I wanted to see Hamlet's reaction if he saw Horatio being hit on, and I was not pleased with the end result.
Ophelia, I'm sorry. I swear I didn't know you two were still dating.
But how could you not know?
He lied to me. I never thought he'd lie to me.
Yeah, sure.
No, really, Ophelia, I would never.
Well, I thought we were friends, Horatio.
I would never hurt you.
But you did. You betrayed me. And he betrayed me.
Ophelia, you're so dramatic.
The D word.
Excuse me?
Listen. I know he hurt you, but clearly he hurt me too. I just didn't know it at the time. It doesn't even matter anymore. He's dead. All we're doing is arguing, and we don't even care that someone we all cared about is dead.
Oh my God, Horatio, I'm so sorry.
I never got to say goodbye or tell him how I feel. He's gone.
Poor Horatio.
Hey, guys, it's gonna be okay. They're there.
He really cared about you both.
You guys both deserve better, honestly.
Now's not the time for that, Juliet.
I'm sorry, Ophelia. I swear I didn't know.
No, I'm sorry for accusing you and setting this ridiculous plan in motion. I just wish I could take it all back.
Can we be friends again?
Oh my God. This is all very sweet, but we're still missing something here. We don't know exactly what happened to Hamlet. How did he end up in the exact spot that he'd get hit by a sandbag after interacting with a lot of you? What kind of person was he? Why would someone want him murdered?
Hamlet was an axe!
Hey, I am not... Oh, Hamlet.
Yes.
Yeah.
He was a whiny little jerk. He always had to go and rebel against authority figures.
And he could never make up his mind.
Nope.
He was always stalling, even when we were practicing, taking his sweet time in the wings.
Yep. Oh, and don't even get me started on the pirate incident.
The pirate incident?
Oh my God, the pirate incident.
Yeah, he led that crew to kidnap Pericles' daughter.
No, that was different pirates.
Did Shakespeare have like a thing for pirates or something?
We do not question the bard's choice of dramatic plot devices.
Speak for yourself.
Anyway, Hamlet got way too excited the day Billy brought the cast to the pirate playground.
Honestly, it was a little scary.
It was like out of nowhere he just grew a backbone.
And he took control over the entire ship.
Rosencrantz and Guildenstern lost their heads completely. The poor girls came home in tears.
And he always came up with the most elaborate plans for the simplest tasks. Oh my God, this one time I asked him to deliver a basket to Romeo. Simple task, right? He redid the fly system so the basket would carry up and across the stage instead of, you know, handing it to him. Like a normal person. All right, so what we're getting at here
is that Hamlet was melodramatic as hell.
Yes.
But I still don't see any sort of motive for murdering him.
Can we please just wait for the police?
No, I am the justice now, William!
Chill. How about we ask the audience and the rest of the cast members if they have any questions? Maybe they noticed something that we didn't.
Great idea. Let's line everyone up.
If anyone has any questions that could help shed light on this really frustrating investigation, please. Yes.
Creepy how much you love Stephen King.
Thank you so much.
Yes, yeah, sure. Billy.
Taking forever.
You inspire me to be a better actor.
Thank you.
And Lady McCrazy, thank you for being the waking moment to all my nightmares.
Thank you for saying such sweet things. Next question. Yeah, you, all the way in the back.
I have a question for Billy.
Wow. What is it?
Why did you kill Hamlet?
Oh.
Did you say, why did I kill Hamlet? First of all, that's very accusatory. Secondly, thirdly, Hamlet was supposed to die in Act 5. We didn't even get past Act 1. Why would I derail my own show? It is a great question! Do you have any answers for me?
No, that's why I asked you. You know better than I would.
I'm afraid he thinks too literally for you. Next question.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes,
Rebecca,
if you knew that your father, so-called, in this incident, or what did you stop him and tell the whole cast?
Well, originally my father's plan was just to have a set piece fly in, you know, a shooting star or something. But obviously that's not what happened. So had the original plan been as detrimental as the outcome was, I would have said something, but no one was supposed to get hurt.
Any other questions? Yes, you.
Horatio, was the lady fluffing on her?
Did you have to ask?
This is very triggering.
No, I can do this. So a few years ago, my mom bought me for my birthday Lady Fluffernutter. She was this beautiful, silky brown rabbit. And Ophelia, Hamlet, and I, we've known each other for a long time. We always used to play with her, just sort of, you know, pet her.
Great rabbit.
It was wonderful. And one day, it was a couple of weeks after I had gotten her, I picked her up and I was like, oh, Lady Fluffernutter, you're so lovely. And I hugged her and... And she didn't get up.
Horatio's love is Horatio's love is a little much for all of us, actually. Any other questions? Yeah, you.
This one's for Demetrius. You and Hamlet both seem to have an interest in Horatio. Do you mean that you would have killed him so that you could have Horatio all to yourself?
on Horatio for Ophelia, first off. Second off, I mean, he's all right. I wouldn't have gone for him first. I mean, yeah. I'm more to the single dad type.
Next question. Yes.
Everyone wants to know about Marcia. You see, Miranda's mother and I were married for quite some time, and 3 years ago, the three of us decided to take a trip to Hawaii. It was going to be a great family vacation, and we went snorkeling and scuba diving, and one day we decided to go surfing. So we hired a surfing instructor, and his name was Big Mahala Kalala. Anyway, and it was great. He was great. He was a lifeguard as well, so we knew we were in safe hands. He had us standing up in half an hour, and you know, not perfectly. And so Marcia, my wife at the time, was standing up on one of the largest waves we'd ever seen that day, and she, you know, got all shaky and she fell off, and it terrified me. My heart stopped. And after that, her lungs filled with water. It was terrifying. And Big Mahala Kalala, he hurled her to shore, and he performed CPR. And well, I guess they call it the kiss of life for one reason, because for the rest of the vacation, it was, oh, what a nice guy was that Big Mahala Kalala. Oh, what a strong man was that Big Mahala Kalala. What a gentle soul that Big Mahala Kalala. How heroic was Big Mahala Kalala. How great is Big Mahala Kalala.
Now they're happily married in Hawaii. Any other questions?
So that's why I'm a single father.
Next question. Yes.
That's an excellent question. Why am I here? So, I already said I was just watching in the wings because, you know, I get bored talking to people. Then I kind of drive people away, if you haven't noticed. So, yeah, if you guys want to let me know why the fuck I'm up here, that'd be pretty dandy. So, yeah, incompetence, basically.
Any other questions? Yes.
Got a question for Billy and I guess Nick. What place are you from?
Well.
What are you supposed to represent?
Well, my parents named me after Billy Joel. You know Billy Joel.
Oh, Billy Joel, of course.
He had to be a big shot, didn't he? Yes. Yeah, there you go. I'm not a character, though. I'm Billy Pearson. That's my real name.
All your friends are so knocked out.
Yeah. I like this guy.
Yes, and I am from A Midsummer's Night Dream.
Oh, yeah.
Wonderful show. Okay. It's me.
Wonderful.
I
must have forgotten.
Oh,
we get it. Oh, well.
You can step back.
I'm sorry, I don't.
No, it's really fine.
It's not your fault.
Sorry, Bob.
She's not a very good actress.
Next question.
Yes.
Bottom couldn't pay me off to be Hamlet. I wouldn't accept any money from her, honestly. I don't know.
Any other questions? Yes, you're up front.
Nick Bottom, how do you feel about being the Weaver? Do you like the role? Was it your dream role?
You know, actors tend to take what they are given, and I am always given something great. And I knew that I could take Nick Bottom, the Weaver, and make it something fantastic. Regardless of what it was and how stupid Billy was to put me in that role because he had no idea how great I am. But besides that, I am a fantastic Nick Bottom and a wonderful Weaver. And I do my best.
You mispronounced subpar.
You, Billy,
are an ass?
Yes, an ass! Ugh. Isn't that funny?
Yes, ironic.
Okay, so before someone else gets murdered, next question. Yes, you with the backwards ball cap.
My question is for Horatio.
Hello.
All right, so your reasoning for going after Hamlet was that you thought that they were broken up, right? Him and Ophelia. But then if you were actually friends with Ophelia, wouldn't you not go after the man that she just broke up with?
He got you.
I can do this. So, as I said earlier when talking about Lady Fluffernutter, Hamlet, Ophelia, and I have known each other for a very long time, and when they started dating, I'm going to admit I was jealous, and when I had learned that they had broken up, I was weak, and I regret that.
I'm sorry.
Wow. Before I vomit, next question.
Juliet's got something.
Oh, what?
Yeah, I got this.
Go!
Okay, thanks.
So
a real question. Yeah.
What were you doing backstage?
Well, I was actually, first of all, having some trouble with my lines, so I was just running them. Second of all, I knew that something was supposed to fly in. I kind of wanted to see what it was.
No.
Backstage in the wings, that's where you see all the best stuff. Mm-hmm. Or the worst.
Any other questions in the audience? Yes, you with the scarf.
Who is the person of highest authority here? All right.
Mutiny.
Who are we more scared of?
All right, fuck you.
The body in the back, did you make sure to draw a little chalk or white marker outline around?
Actually, due to some previous experiences that I've had, I've decided that we no longer mess with crime scenes. So, no.
To give you a legal answer, you don't tamper with a crime scene.
That's it.
I know what I'm talking about. Next question. Yeah.
So, Prospero, you kind of have a reputation for getting other people to do your dirty work. Why can't you do it yourself?
Well, he's not very good at it in the first place.
He did such a great job.
Exactly.
Thank you, Miranda. She gets something. Anyway, listen. I honestly expected Puck to have forgotten about having anything to do with what happened. That, and since nothing was supposed to, go wrong, I honestly just thought that he would have forgotten, and if something had come up about it, that no one would have known what would have happened. So it would have just kind of gone as a mystery, and everyone would have been fine, but I guess some things change.
I have a question.
Yes?
Hey, babe, can you get me some more pie?
Oh my God.
That's like your 6-piece.
Listen, someone was murdered. I'm really stressed. Please?
Fine.
Thank you. I love her. And pie.
Next question.
Demetrius, you've hooked up with a lot of people in the cafe.
No.
Yeah, what was that?
Talent, I don't want to
go. You know, I thought about it, but then, you know, it's too much baggage. I just don't want to get mixed up with any of that or any of that. You know, too much work.
You might even say sand baggage.
Oh my
Someone
God.
Someone has been murdered, Lady Macbeth.
Use a little soon.
I'm sorry, I make myself laugh.
Wow.
No one else.
That's pretty funny, actually.
Anyone else have questions? Yes, yeah.
Beatrice, you jumped pretty fast onto the I'm gonna be the investigator. Was that to cover up that you actually did it? No, I was in the audience during the time of the murder. You know, Ophelia was about to make her debut in a female lead role here, so I wanted to watch her. There's no way it could have been me. So that's... Next question? Yeah.
Since we have a murderer on the loose, I was curious, do any of you, could you guess
one or two more questions before we get back to our
real investigation. Anyone else? Yes, you.
I think we can all.
One being negative one. Like the best?
In terms of skill?
Yeah. One's low. Mm.
Okay.
All
can
right.
We start?
Let's all count down. We'll count down from three, and we'll all say it at the same time.
Okay.
That way, there's no blame on any one person in particular.
Right.
Got it.
Ready?
I'm
three.
No.
Two. One.
100 million.
It was under a pile of costumes, but I saw its handle sticking out.
But that's a prop. It should have been on the props table.
It's engraved, isn't it?
Indeed it is. It says here it belongs to Patrice Goldman.
What did you just say?
Patrice Goldman?
I know no one by the name of Patrice Goldman.
Son of a fuck! William, someone is dead. Can you please drop your fucking method acting for 1 second! We have actual lives, you know!
Isn't that Bottom's real name?
Yes. Yes, that is my name. And that is my knife. I got it at the Renaissance Fair. Keep it in the Shakespearean mindset and all. Normal activity.
Well, then why was it backstage under a pile of costumes?
I must have dropped it. That darn gravity.
That's suspicious. You know, it having fallen out of its sheath and everything.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Well, this is ridiculous. It's just my knife and I dropped it. And I don't like your tone. Who even put you in charge in the first place? Why aren't you a suspect?
I wasn't even backstage at the time of Hamlet's murder.
Yeah, but you were mad at Hamlet, weren't you? You could have elaborately planned for those sandbags to fall on him, Lady Macbeth!
When was I mad at Hamlet?
She does have a point. You were mad at him at Iago's birthday party last week. He spilled red wine all over your new dress.
But that damn spot just wouldn't come out! It left a giant stain!
Rest my case, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, but I wouldn't kill a man over something like that. I'm not irrational!
Stop trying to change the subject, Bottom. Lady Macbeth is clearly innocent here.
Thank you.
Why are we even still talking about this? We all know that Puck is the one responsible, and that I'm innocent too.
Oh.
Are you?
No!
I was backstage looking for some clues.
Wait, that's a great idea.
Why didn't we think of that?
And I found this in Bottom's dressing room.
What is it?
A script. Well, that's not exactly out of place. She is an actress.
Yes, but it's a copy of Hamlet with a part of Hamlet highlighted and completely annotated.
Oh my God.
Why do you have a completely annotated version of Hamlet, Miss Bottom, if that even is your real name?
It's not my real name.
I knew that.
It's Goldman.
I was just preparing for another audition. There are other productions of Hamlet besides ours, people.
But what about the knife?
Your story just isn't adding up. Bottom.
Why would you need a knife on you?
And why are you backstage in the first place?
Were you really just trying to cheer us on?
Or were you trying to get an alibi?
And why do you have that script?
Weren't you ready to take the role the minute we found Hamlet dead?
Yes.
You asshole, what have you done?
I did it for my craft!
I'm sorry, for your what?
I deserved that role! I deserve all your roles! But Hamlet has been my dream role for the longest time, and that punk got it! I don't think so! I have worked day in and day out, learning this part, studying this character, truly understanding his nature, and you put me as Nick Bottom, the Weaver! What even is a Weaver, Billy? I deserve that role. I deserve Hamlet.
You just weren't right for the part, I'm sorry. But you seem delighted to get Bottom.
That was acting!
What did you do to Hamlet?
I was lurking backstage, interacting with the cast of Hamlet, playing their games, earning their trust, when I was going to stab! I had my dagger at my side, ready to stab
at a moment's notice. I waited until they got alone. Hamlet was doing yoga in the left wing. I saw Puck and Demetrius on the other side screwing around when I noticed the sandbag falling. And blood. It's just so messy from a stab wound. Why ruin my perfectly good knife when all Hamlet needed was a little push in the right direction?
You murderer!
What?
What are you thinking?
What the hell?
Dude, you killed someone for a part? What kind of moron?
I deserve that role! I deserve Hamlet!
So you killed someone?
Oh, you're one to talk. You killed a king because some witches told you to.
I never actually killed anyone. That is acting! You cream-faced loon!
Bottom, how could you?
This is insanity!
What in God's name is going on here? I leave for 45 minutes and return to this!
I hear this man will heal.
Don't worry, officer. We got to the bottom of it.
Oh my God.
This is Miranda.